Hello students, welcome back to GS Maths. Today we will discuss the word problems based on the concept of maxima and minima. Again, it's an application of the differentiation, right? We have discussed in my previous lectures that how to find the maximum value of the function, how to find the minimum value of the function using those three tests. The first was the first derivative test, second higher order derivative test. Second was when an interval was given to you, we had to find the absolute maximum and the minimum value of a given function. Now the next concept is word problems, applied problems which are based on this maximum and minimum. I have written a question for you. Question is, a point on the hypotenuse at a distance A and B from two sides of a right angle triangle, then we have to show that the length of the hypotenuse is minimum. It is equal to this. We have to minimize the length of the hypotenuse. Now, what we are going to do is, say I have a triangle, right angle triangle, a right angled triangle, say OAB, right? It is right angled at O. Now, according to the question, a point on the hypotenuse, let that point be P, is at a distance A from this side and distance B from the other side. A point on the hypotenuse is at a distance A from OA side and at a distance B from OB side. Now we have to minimize the length. Let the total length of the hypotenuse AB equals to L. Now AB equals to L, that means the length is AP plus PB. Now, let this angle be theta. If this angle is theta, this line is parallel to the base, so this angle will also be theta. Now, what I can do, I can find out the length of this portion using trigonometric ratios. I can find out the length of PB again using trigonometric ratios. Now, this is the perpendicular, this is the hypotenuse in triangle OAP. If say, let me have it, it is N point, this is M point. Now, PN upon AP is sine of theta. I need length of AP, that is PN upon sine theta is AP. Now, PN is A, that is I can write AP as A cosecant theta. Write this. AP is A cosecant theta. Similarly, I can find length of PB. Use the trigonometric ratio again. Base upon the hypotenuse, that is base is MP upon the hypotenuse PB. PB equals to cos of theta. Now what is MP? MP is B. That means B upon cos theta. PB is B upon cos theta. It is B secant of theta. Right? Now this is A cosecant theta, this portion. And PB is B secant theta. So my total length of the hypotenuse is AP plus PB. So I get the length of the hypotenuse is AP. AP is what? A cosecant theta plus PB is what? B secant of theta. Right? Now I have to minimize this length. Length of the hypotenuse. So what I can do is, I can just differentiate this with respect to theta. So my dl by d theta is A. What is the derivative of cosecant theta? It is minus cosecant theta cotangent theta plus b is a constant secant theta derivative secant theta into tan theta. Now change this into sine and cos. What do you get? dl by d theta is minus a. So secant theta is 1 upon sine theta. Cot theta is cos upon sine theta. So it becomes cos upon sine square theta. Cos theta upon sine square theta. Then plus b times. This is sine upon cos. This is 1 by cos. So it becomes sine theta upon cos square theta. Right, now I can take the LCM dl by d theta or leave it. We can find the second derivative also from here only. Right, so just let me find d square l by d theta square. I will differentiate this. It's better to differentiate this. Now a as it is, rather minus a as it is. So secant theta into cotangent theta, use the product rule, say cosec theta as it is, cot ka derivative minus cosecant square plus cot, so secant theta ka derivative cosecant theta minus cosecant theta cotangent theta, phir plus b times secant theta into tan theta, first function derivative of tan plus second function derivative of first. If I take out minus common from here, right, so yahan pe kya ban jayega plus, so d square l by d theta square is, if I take minus common from here, let me check it. Minus was already there. Cosecant theta, cotangent theta, minus cosecant square, plus cot, cosecant ka cosecant into minus of cosecant into cotangent. Right. Now, just solve this and change into sine and cos. Now, I have to find value of theta here. Now, put this equals to 0 first. Let me put it minus a cos theta divided by sine square theta equals to negative b sine theta upon cos square theta. Now negative with negative goes, sine cube upon cos cube is a upon b sine cube theta upon cos cube theta, that is tan of cube theta. Now, if it is tan of cube theta, that becomes tan of theta is equal to a upon b raised to power 1 by 3. I'll get the value of tan theta as a upon b into this. A upon b raised to power 1 by 3. Now, I have this. I have to show that this is positive at tan theta equals to a by b raised to power 1 by 3. Now just change these into sine and cos to make it easy. Okay? Then put the value of tan theta over here. Say I have tan theta as a 1 by 3 divided by b 1 by 3. Just solve the triangle. It is base, the perpendicular upon base, a 1 by 3 b 1 by 3. So what does the hypotenuse will be? Hypotenuse will be under root of a 2 by 3 plus b 2 by 3. Right? So I can have the values of sine as well as cos. Sine theta will be perpendicular upon a 1 by 3 upon hypotenuse, that is a 2 by 3 plus b 2 by 3. Similarly, I can have the value of cos theta as b 1 by 3 divided by under root of a 2 by 3 plus b 2 by 3. So I can solve the triangle and get the values of the other t ratios, that is sine and cos. Now, why I have done it sine and cos? I have to minimize this length. Now, at tan theta equals to d, this will be positive. After substituting the value, I will get the positive sign over here. ठीक है, अगर positive sign है, that means the length of the hypotenuse is minimum at tan theta equals to a upon b raised to power 1/3. But I have to find this length. So I can find the length by using this L equals to a cosec theta plus b secant theta. I will find it over here. Let me have these values sine and cos. Sine theta is perpendicular over hypotenuse and cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. So I will write these values over here. Sine theta is a 1/3 divided by under root of a 2/3 plus b 2/3. Cos theta is b 1/3 divided by under root of a 2/3 plus b 2/3. These are the values of sine and cos. Now I have to find the length of the hypotenuse and prove that it is equal to this. Okay, L equals to a. So secant theta was there. I can write this as 1 plus cot square theta under the root. Right, I have an identity cosecant square theta equals to 1 plus cot square theta. So what I have done, cosecant theta is under root of 1 plus cot square theta plus b secant theta. Secant theta is nothing but 1 plus tan square theta. Right, I can fill the values of a. That is, now I had value of tan theta. I had the value of tan theta. The cot is reciprocal of tan. Now I can write it as 1 plus b 2/3 a 2/3. Right? Plus b times 1 plus tan theta is a 1/3 b. It is a 2/3 b 2/3. We can directly substitute the value of tan theta, or we can put up the value of cosecant as 1 upon sine. That's why I calculated this value. We can write secant theta as 1 upon cos theta. Put this value then. Otherwise, L equals to A, it was cosecant theta. So I can write cosecant theta as this plus B. Secant theta can be written like this. Now put the values, we will get the required answer. A 2/3, B 2/3, right, divided by A 2/3 raised to power half, it will be A 1/3 only, then plus B, similarly over here, B 1/3 under root of A 2/3 plus B 2/3. So what is common in it? I get 1 minus of this, A 1 minus 1/3. That is 2/3 plus, rather this is common, a 2/3 plus b 2/3 b 2/3 under root of a 2/3 plus b raised to power 2/3. Now under root of a 2/3 plus b 2/3 is common. I will write over here so that it is visible to you, all of you, right? Now, this is under root of a 2/3 plus b 2/3 is common. So within brackets, it will be a 2/3 plus b raised to power 2/3. This power is half, this power is 1. They get added. I get a 2/3 plus b raised to power 2/3 whole raised to power 3/2. This is my length of the hypotenuse. I have proved it. The length is minimum when angle tan theta is a upon b whole raised to power 1/3, or I can write like this. This is the length. I had to prove it equal to this, the minimum length. It is there. A raised to power 2/3 plus b raised to power 2/3. It was given there is a p point at a distance a and at a distance b from the two sides of the right angle triangle. What we have to prove
कि ए बी जो लेंथ है हाइपोटेन्यूज की दिस इज मिनिमम. तो व्हाट वी डिड वी यूज्ड ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज टू फाइंड दिस पोर्शन एंड दिस पोर्शन. द टोटल लेंथ वॉज एल इज ए पी प्लस बी बी डिड लाइक दिस राइट. आई होप सो दैट यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सम बट इट्स ईजी वन. ओनली यू वॉन्ट टू नो दिस फिगर हाउ टू ड्रॉ इट एंड डिफ्रेंशिएशन. इट्स एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डिफ्रेंशिएशन. नाउ आई विल डू अनदर गुड क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सम अगेन. नाउ क्वेश्चन इज Find the shortest distance of the point. Find the shortest distance of the point 0, C from the parabola. Y equals to x here, where 0 less than equal to c less than equal to 5. The value of c is either 0 or 5 or in between 0 and 5. Now what we will do is we will try to solve it. The point is 0 comma c. This is a parabola. X here equals to 4y. It is a this kind of parabola open from the upper end like this. There is say a point P on the parabola XY and 0 comma C obvious as it will lie somewhere here. 0 comma C, this is my point M. So I join this. I have to minimize this shortest distance, minimize this distance PM. Now I can use the PM distance formula. It is under root of x minus 0 square plus y minus c square under the root. Right? Now I get under root of x square plus y minus c the square. Now what is y equals to x square? That is, I get x square plus x square minus c whole square. This is your PM distance. Let this be equal to say z. Z equals to PM is under root of x square plus this. If I open this up, I get x square x4 plus c square minus 2 c x square under the root, right? So it is x4 plus x square common 1 minus 2c plus c square under the root. Now let me have it PM, right? Now square both the sides. It will be easy for us to solve. PM square equals to the under root goes x4 plus x square into 1 minus 2c plus c square. Let this PM square be equal to z. Now it will be much easier. Now what I have to do? I have to minimize this distance, the shortest distance, okay? It is dz by dx. Now it is 4x cube plus 1 minus 2c as it is x square. It is 2x. C square is a constant, so its derivative is 0. Now, I will put, again, let me do the second derivative over here only. It will be 12x square plus 1 minus 2c into 2. I differentiated this, I get this. Now, I have to put, minimize or maximize, I have to put this first derivative equal to 0. So dz by dx equals to 0. That is 4x cube plus 2x 1 minus 2c equals to 0. Now 2x is common, I get 2x square plus 1 minus 2c equals to 0. Either x is 0 or 2x square becomes 2c minus 1. I have taken this to this side, so here minus 1, here plus 2c, or x square is 2c minus 1 by 2. X की वैल्यू है अंडर रूट ऑफ 2c माइनस 1 अपॉन 2. नाउ इफ आई पुट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ x हियर ओवर हियर आई गेट ऑब्वियसली अ पॉजिटिव आंसर. दिस विल बी अ पॉजिटिव आंसर बिकॉज x हियर विल बी 2c माइनस 1 अपॉन 2. वी कैन शो ओवर हियर दैट इज से लेट मी पुट अप d स्क्वायर z बाय dx स्क्वायर is 12. What is the value of x square? X square is 2c minus 1 upon 2. 2c minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 minus 2c into 2. Now 6, I get 12c minus 6 plus 2 minus 4c. That is 12c, it is 8c minus of 4. This is positive because c की value जो है it is either equal to 0 or equal to 5 or it is lies in between 0 and 5. Now it's always positive. Look here, I have got minus 6 12 c 2c minus 1. I will put up over here x here 2c minus 1 by 2. I have substituted over x here की value 1 minus 2c into 2. When I open up, I get 12c minus 6 plus 2 minus 4c. 12c minus this is this, 8c minus 4. This always remains positive. So the distance will be minimum at x equals to 2c minus 1 by 2. Now I have to minimize the distance. Just fill the value of x here over here, right? Or right here you can find the value of the distance, that is PM equals to x square. X square is 2c minus 1 by 2 plus, it's again x square, 2c minus 1 by 2 minus c is the square under the root. When you solve it, 2c with 2c goes, 1 by 4 is left, so that is 2c minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 under the root. We can solve this and we can find the minimum distance, that is PM distance. P is a point on the parabola and M is a point 0, comma C on the y-axis. This is the way we will do this question. Hope you have understood it. Next sum again we will do, which is again a very good sum, but in that sum also it's our imagination, it's our making up of the figure which makes us understand that question. Now question is a given quantity of metal is to be cast into a half cylinder. Given quantity of metal is to be done into a half cylinder. Okay, let me draw that, try to draw that half cylinder like this. Right. It's a half cylinder. A given quantity of metal is to be cast into a half cylinder with a rectangular base. This base is rectangular, right? Now rectangular hai to iski height cylinder ki half cylinder hai. This is half cylinder, right? These are the circular ends, semicircular ends. This is the rectangular portion. These are semicircular ends, ends. This one is also semicircular, this, right? Now, what I can do is, let the diameter of the semicircular ends be 2r. Given क्या है देखो, question है, a given quantity of metal is to be cast into a half cylinder with a rectangular base and semicircular ends. Show that in order that the total surface area may be minimum, total surface area may be minimum, the ratio of length of the cylinder to the diameter of the semicircular ends. That means we have to show the height of the cylinder divided by the diameter of the semicircular ends, that is 2r, is pi upon pi plus 2. This we have to prove. Now let me prove this. It is given, this is a half cylinder, ठीक है? अगर half cylinder है तो volume of half cylinder is half times pi r square into h. Radius is r, height is h. This is v equals to this. From here, just find the value of h equals to 2v divided by pi r square. I get height equals to 2v divided by pi r square. Now, I have to minimize the total surface area. Now, find the total surface area. Total surface area kya hai? These are two semicircular ends. Okay. 2 multiplied by area of the semicircular ends. Radius kitna hai? R. Total circle ka area hota pi r square. Iska half pi r square, iska half pi r square. That is 2 times half pi r square. This is the surface area of these two semicircular ends. Now area of the rectangular base, this is rectangle. Rectangle, that is length. Length multiplied by breadth, it becomes h into 2r. Then this surface area, the curved surface area of the half cylinder, total hota 2 pi r, right? 2 pi r into h. So it is half, so it will become pi r h plus pi r h. The total curved surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h plus the area of these two surfaces. Now I have to find only the curved surface area. I have taken the semicircular ends over here, the rectangular base over here, uska area, ab half semicircle ka cylinder ka area, that is curved surface area. Total curved surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h. It is half of it, so that is only pi r h. This 2 which 2 goes, I get surface area equals to pi r square plus 2rh plus pi rh, right? I can take out pi r square plus 2r plus pi r into h. Let me take, say, r common from here also. That means it is 2 plus pi into rh. This is your surface area. ठीक है? अब from this, h equals to 2v by pi r square, substitute the value of h over here. I get s equals to pi r square plus 2 plus pi r as it is. Now, what is the value of h from here? Here, h equals 2v upon pi r square. Put the value 2v upon pi r square. That is pi r square plus r with r cancels. 2 plus pi 2v upon pi r. This is your s. 2V upon pi R. I have substituted the value of H from this. H equals to 2V upon pi R square. I have put up there. Right? Now, we can solve this using derivative ds by dr. I will differentiate. What I get? 2 pi r derivative 2 plus pi by pi into 2. V is constant. 1 upon r ka derivative aa jayega minus 1 upon r square. This becomes 2 pi r plus 2v upon pi 2 plus pi r square, put up a minus sign over it. Right? Now, this is ds by dr. Now, if I derivate it again, I get 2 pi minus 2v by pi 2 plus pi r square, 1 upon r square is r raised to power minus 2. So I get minus 2 upon r cube. So mera jo d square s by d r square aa gaya, that is 2 pi minus minus becomes plus 4 v upon pi r cube pi plus 2. This is positive, sir. It is 2 pi plus 4v upon pi r square pi plus 2. This is positive. So, if it is positive, then my surface area will be minimum. And how to prove the height of this cylindrical part divided by the radius or diameter of the semicircular lens is pi upon pi plus 2. Now, I had ds by dr equals to this. So I can put this equal to 0. I will put this equal to 0. Now what happens? Like this. Let me rub this off. This ds by dr is 0. This gives me ds by dr equals to 0. That means 2 pi r equals to 2 v pi r square 2 plus pi. Now 2 with 2 goes, again pi square r cube is v 2 plus pi. Okay, now h equals to 2 v upon pi r square. Can I substitute the value of v over here as pi square r cube is v ki value kya banegi? Pi r square by 2, that is pi r square h by 2, 2 plus pi. Now this pi with pi cancels, r square with r goes, this becomes 2 r upon h. 2 r upon h is 2 plus pi upon pi. Just flip the things. H upon 2R is pi upon 2 plus pi. That is height of the cylindrical portion divided by diameter of the semicircular lens is in the ratio pi ratio 2 plus pi. This I had to prove by proving that the surface area, total surface area of this half cylinder is minimum. This I have proved by taking this second derivative plus mein aa raha hai. Agar positive aa raha hai, so that means ki my surface area is minimum. Aur maine ds by dr ko 0 ke equal karo, you get 2r by h is pi plus 2 upon pi. Just swap the things, just take the reciprocal on both the sides to get h upon 2r is pi upon 2 plus pi, which means height of the cylindrical portion divided by the diameter of the semicircular lens is in the ratio pi ratio pi plus 2. I hope you have understood these questions. These are very good sums and you just have to make the figure out of which to understand the concept what the question wants from you. Thanks for watching my video, and please subscribe my channel GS Maths as much as you can. Thanks once again. Take care. Stay safe.